Welcome at Engineer's Kitchen. When visiting production sites, I'm very often confronted with the term of SPC. Alexander, can you tell me more about it?
Yeah, SPC is Statistical Process Control and is a method of quality control which use statistical methods to monitor and process control a process.
Okay.
SPC can be used for any process where the output is measurement, mm-hmm. can be measured.
Okay.
An advantage of SPC over other methods of quality mm-hmm. controls, such as inspection, is that you can early prevent and react mm-hmm. on some problems in your process.
So during the production process,
yes, of course.
Yeah.
It.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
That's really great. And yeah, I have prepared an example because since the latest analyzer version, we have some great statistic process control report template in them.
Good,
and maybe I will show you one of them.
Yeah, looking forward to it.
Okay, first of all, the question is, what do you need to use this report? Huh? It's really easy. You just need a little zenon project. I've prepared one. It's not pretty, but it works. Mm-hmm. This represents a screw nut factory. Mm-hmm. And we produce the diameter of the screw nuts.
Okay.
So the specification of the screw nut diameter is 10.1, and we have a range of plus minus 0.2 millimeters.
Mm-hmm. So which is then still the good parts? This is the quality range.
Yes, all parts must be in this tolerance because otherwise the screw nut will not go on the screw.
Course.
So that's really important. And so we got this measurement, and you can put this measure, this value, or the values in a zenon archive. That's all what you need.
Okay,
so then you can use the report, mm-hmm. and all other things is done with on the report. Yes, of course you have to do some parameters settings, but it's not so bad. Okay, let's see just the report.
Have a look at the output.
Yes. Now we see the report. This report includes three different templates. The mm-hmm. first template shows the process capability.
Mm-hmm.
The second part is the control chart.
Okay.
And the third part is the histogram. I will tell you about the details later. Mm-hmm. First, we will start with these two indicators. These two indicators, the CP and the CPK mm-hmm. indicators, are really important and give you a quick overview of how your process works.
So if it's good or bad.
It's good or bad, more or less, yes, of course. The CP value is the time, how often goes the speed of your process mm-hmm. in the specification range.
Mm-hmm.
So if you have just a value with one, that means you can just put it one time in your tolerance. So that's not so good mm-hmm. because you have not move around. So, but this will be happening in the process mm-hmm. because the adjustment of the machine is not so good or something mm-hmm. else.
So you're at the lower end of the quality.
Yeah, of course. So this indicator should be over 1.33.
Okay.
So in this case, it works fine. We have no problem.
Mm-hmm.
The second indicator, the CP key, is the index which measure how close or how far mm-hmm. your process works on the limits mm-hmm. of the tolerance limits on the upper or lower side.
Mm-hmm.
So if the higher this value are, the less you will produce waste.
Okay.
So if this indicator is more than 1.33, so everything looks fine
good.
And you have no waste in your process. Okay, this is just a quick overview about your process, but maybe you want to know a little bit more. Maybe you want to monitor and you want to see the trend of your process. So in this case, you can use the chart control.
Mm-hmm.
The chart control, the most cases use two chart controls, one for the average and one for the standard deviation.
Mm-hmm.
And each mark on this line represent a specified number of error edges.
Wow. So kind of sampling?
Sampling, yeah. Okay. Yeah. Chat controls work only for sampling. That's the only point. So this green line represents the specification value. So it's 10.1. And you can see the line goes always around our specification value. It looks good. Mm-hmm. But we have some problems here, mm-hmm. and really we have a problem here and here. In this case, if you violate the warning lines, mm-hmm. the orange line, the warning lines, mm-hmm. that means you should do something with your process, because your process is going in the wrong...
It's getting issues.
Yeah, of course. So, but in this case, if you don't reach the red line, it means still all your values
are good.
Is good. So you don't produce a waste, so that's great. The same is like the standard deviation here. But if you have the problem here and here, so you reach the red line, so have maybe you have great waste and you have to do something with them. So, and yeah, and you see really everything what happens on your process with one view. The histogram gives you a whole overview of all your measurements. So in this case, we have a really cool bell curve. Mm-hmm. The distribution of your measurements looks good. The average or the specification value mm-hmm. is exactly here. It's around 10.1, so that's great. And these green lines represent the standard deviation mm-hmm. for one okay. or for two sigma.
Yeah.
And around in this case, you should have more than 60% of your measurements. Oh. In this case, it works, it looks good, and even the border of your measurements mm-hmm. are behind the specification tolerance. Mm-hmm. So in this case, you have a good process.
Nothing to do.
Nothing everybody's to do, happy. Yeah, and everybody's happy.
Great. Thanks, Alexander, for this very impressive insight. As a little thank you, I want to offer you one of our Engineer's Kitchen t-shirts.
That's nice.
And hopefully I can see you soon again at another edition.
Okay.
Thank you for joining Engineer's Kitchen.
Bye.
What a delicious episode of COPA-DATA's Engineer's Kitchen. If you are still hungry, please subscribe to our YouTube channel.